Code Golf.
Hello everyone, welcome to the second episode of Code Golf. In this video, we are going to solve the FizzBuzz problem. Before we start with the FizzBuzz problem, shout out to Imad Ismail for breaking my score on divisors. I scored 76 and he came up with an awesome short code and he finished the divisors problem in just 64 characters. I really love this kind of well-spirited competition where we are trying to beat each other's code by learning new things about our favorite programming language. So today, if you beat my FizzBuzz problem score, go ahead to Twitter and tweet to me at @pylenin, I broke your FizzBuzz score with dash characters, and you fill in the blank with the number of characters that you have. So let's get started. Now we already know what FizzBuzz problem is, right? If you haven't watched my video on FizzBuzz problem, click on the I link and watch my video and then come back to the code golf thing so we all can compete. So let's just write a basic code to solve the FizzBuzz problem. Let's not worry about how short our code is. Let's just write a simple code to solve it. So here I can say for I in range 1 to 101. It's until 100, right? Yeah, 100 inclusive. If I percentage 15 equal to 0, print FizzBuzz elif I percentage 5 equal to 0, print buzz elif I percentage 3 equal to 0, print fizz. Pretty simple, right? It's just if else inside a for loop. Else, let's not forget the last important part, print I. Cool, so it is passing our test, everything is awesome, and the number of characters we have used is 145, which is kind of a lot, right? So let's reduce it. So the basic things that we can take care of, we don't need this space, right? We can put the if clause and the print statement in the same line, saves us some characters, 5 characters actually. Then let's just do that for everything. Okay. Now if I run this, so we are getting the right result and we have 125 characters. So from 145, we have come down to 125. So remember, you can actually put if clause and print statement in the same line. You don't have to put them in different lines. However, it reduces readability, but you know, that's not the game. Readability is not the game. We just have to write the code in the shortest way possible. So let's reduce the code even further. Here you can see, I have multiple if, elif, else statements, right? There is a short way in Python how we can write multiple if, elif, else statements so that our characters will be less, but the functionality will still be the same. I will show you how we can do it. So here you can see, I have x equal to 10 and y equal to 20. Let's do a small, experiment on those. So here I can write a normal if, elif clause here. So I can say if x greater than y, print 1, doesn't have to be anything solid, else print 0, right? Simple loop, simple if elif statement. So if I run this, we'll get 0. Now there is a short way in which we can write this whole if else condition. What I can do is simply write, let's remove this unnecessary, print x greater than y and 1 or 0. So basically, actually, you know what, let me first copy this and then you can see the comparison basically. So here basically the if clause I'm writing first here, x greater than y, and if x greater than y, what do we print? I'm writing as and 1, else we write or 0. So basically this is the shorthand notation of writing an if else statement in Python. So if I run this, you see we receive 0 both the times. So let's go ahead and use this logic in our FizzBuzz problem. Let's go back to the FizzBuzz problem. Here I can say for I in range 101, print. Okay, first condition, I percentage 15 equal to 0, right? Brackets are wrong. Be careful of the brackets. This is one problem with this IDE. It doesn't support formatting. So I percentage 15 equal to equal to 0. And what do we print? We print FizzBuzz, right? And FizzBuzz. Or again brackets, I percentage 5 equal to equal to 0 and buzz, right? If I percentage 5 is equal to equal to 0, we print buzz. Or I percentage 3 equal to equal to 0, we print and fizz. Or we just print I, right? Let's go ahead and check if this is working. Oh, cool, it's working. So basically, this is how we can, and we have actually come down from 125 to 107 characters. You know what? We don't need these brackets actually, I think. If I just try on one of these and see, yeah. So we don't need these brackets around this I percentage 5, I percentage 3. We can remove them and we'll actually get some extra characters. Cool. So we have come down from 125 characters to 101 characters. We can come down even further. We don't, as I said, you can put if else conditions or for conditions with the print statement in one line. So if I remove this, if I run this, cool, it's working. And we are now at 98 characters. So kind of a huge improvement already, you know. So let's see how we can reduce this even further. You know, I could do the same thing in a much shorter way if I just look at fizz and buzz. I don't have to write fizz buzz all the time. So let's do something. Here I can say, before or, let's remove everything here. Yeah, let's say something like this. So basically we are going to use booleans here. So basically brackets, I percentage 5 equal to equal to 0 into 5 is buzz, right? Buzz. You know what? Let's do it like this. Fizz plus I percentage 3 equal to equal to 0 into buzz. So you see what I'm doing here? I'm making use of booleans. So if I percentage 3 is equal to equal to 0, then it returns true. True is basically 1 in Python, right? So then if something is divisible by 3, then we have fizz. And if something is divisible by 5, that's a mistake here, then it's buzz. So then these strings get added together. So basically if something is divisible by both 3 and 5, we get fizz plus buzz. If something is only divisible by 3, we only get fizz. If something is only divisible by 5, we only get buzz. I think it should work, you know. Let's run this. Cool, man, it's working actually. And see, now we have come down to 67 characters, which is pretty cool actually.
So I did it with 67 characters. And on the leaderboard, I'm on the 59th position, which is pretty far actually. It's not that good, but at least my code, I feel, is readable. And I think I did a pretty good job. Now, if you think you can do better, go ahead to Cold Golf and do the FizzBuzz problem. If you beat my score, make sure to tweet it to me. Thank you, everyone. I will see you in the next tutorial.